In the name of Jesus, that's all I need. Silver and gold, I don't have, but such as I have, I'm going to give it to you in the name of Jesus. Somebody give God some glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm almost through. Hallelujah. I told you. People that are crowding these churches, they have a desire and a longing for revelation, and not just any revelation, but true revelation. You can't fault the people, hallelujah, because if you do your research, hallelujah, I'm glad this ain't on tape, I might get in trouble, but if you do your research, all these preachers with these big churches, look back in their background, the name of Jesus is somewhere, hallelujah, they've been baptized in the name of Jesus sometime throughout their life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I maintain that the Bible says, hallelujah, that Jesus said he made the way plain and he made the way straight. Hallelujah, that even a wayward fool can see the way of salvation. He didn't make it complicated. And all these preachers, hallelujah, that are in the word, yeah, they got good revelation. They got good word. Well, if you check your Bible, the devil got good revelation. The devil got real good word. His word is so powerful that he dared to use it against Jesus. Hallelujah, when he met him in the wilderness. And Jesus had to know more word in order to defeat the devil with the word that he took from the Bible. Hallelujah. I tell everybody all the time that the devil is the father of lies. Not because he necessarily gives you a flat out lie, but the devil will tell you the truth with the wrong intention, and that is nothing but a lie. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The devil can use this word for any reason that he needs to use it. That's why the Bible said that the devil is wiser than Daniel. Why am I telling you so much about your enemy? Because it's a wise soldier that knows his adversary. You got to know your enemy's tactics if you want to use something against him. If you want to defeat the enemy, you better know where he's coming from. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I was in a conversation with some people, and they asked me, they wanted to challenge me, and they said, are you telling me, Eric, that I don't have any control over what I do, or that I do have control over everything I do, and the devil is not a part of any of it? I said, eventually and ultimately, you're going to come to the understanding that the devil has no power over you. I'm not talking to somebody that's out in the world. I'm talking to some sanctified, baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost people. The devil has no power over you once you've been born again. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I told them you're going to come to the conclusion that it ain't the devil's fault, and you can't blame him anymore, because if it was the devil's fault, Paul, when he wrote what he wrote in Romans, he said, in me dwells no good thing. He said, in me, I don't find the will to do good. He said, in me, I can't find to do what I want to do for God. He said, but I find that I do the evil that I don't want to do. You got to come to the conclusion that, yeah, the devil can present it, but you have the right and the power to deny anything he presents to you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Once again, got to get back to the message. Where am I going? I told you that the people desire. Are you praying for me? Hallelujah. The people are desiring of a revelation. Hallelujah. And they have to realize this, that I can't get it from my brother or my sister. And they went to the ministers and they went to the pastor looking for a revelation that will fill the emptiness of their souls. But all the pastors and the ministers could do, hallelujah, was show and teach the word. But even the pastor, even the ministers, anybody that come in here to preach to you, they can't really satisfy. They can't come close supposed to satisfy. The hunger that really is in your soul. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And let me tell you something. Apostolic Church of Jesus, you have powerful testimony services. You have people that know how to testify and tell of the goodness of the Lord. But I don't care how many Sundays you come or how many testimonies you hear, no amount of testifying can fill that void for you at all. All it can do is create what they told me was a spiritual jealousy. Hallelujah. They told me this when I watched my sister get baptized in Jesus' name, come up out the water, speaking in tongues, and God filled her with the Holy Ghost. And I've been baptized 3 years prior, still hallelujah, and still tearing, still foaming at the mouth, still crying, still running out of breath. Hallelujah. Caring for the Holy Ghost. And I see my sister who live in the same house, got the same parents, go down in the same water and get up with a different spirit, the spirit of the Holy Ghost. I ran in the office crying, Lord, how come you ain't filling me with the Holy Ghost? I kneeled down at the chair and said, you want the Holy Ghost, don't you? I said, I want the Holy Ghost. She said, well, say hallelujah, hallelujah. And again, I tarried. God still didn't feel me. Hallelujah. I wasn't crying because I really wanted it. I was crying because I was mad at God. How come you not feeling me like you filled her? They call that spiritual jealousy. And that's all testimonies can do. They can provoke you to spiritual jealousy. Well, that's a good thing. That's all right. That just means you want the Lord. That just means when you get tired of watching everybody else get blessed, when you get tired of watching God fill everybody else, when you get tired of hearing about what God can do, you're gonna make up in your mind, hallelujah, pastor can't do it, preacher can't do it, hallelujah, but you got to take your heart back, hallelujah, and bring it back to where it's supposed to be, and give it to the Lord, hallelujah. God said in Isaiah, I see you trying to draw near me. Your words are good from your mouth, and your lips honor me. They're very well. You're doing good with that. But you only know me from what you've heard about me. So your heart then is far from me.